purchase of these almighty slippers. This is from a very respected Canadian grower out west, from Forest View Orchids. Even though these are not blooming size yet, I just absolutely love the quality of their plants. So this first one is a replacement plant. I lost two lady slippers this winter. My Path Lemonade, which had two spikes and then promptly died before it could flower, and this Path Sukhakuliai, which I really love because the flower lasts 3 months. So this is my third attempt at this guy, and if this one doesn't make it, I'm not worthy of growing this one otherwise. This next one is one that I've wanted in a long while, and I just fell in love with the patterning on the leaves. The flower is very cute too. This is another species path, Paphinustum. This is not the album version, it's just a regular one. And where the pouch looks kind of grainy. But look at the leaves on this thing. Just beautiful. And my last acquisition is just a Emodii type. Most of their lady slippers are grown in orchiata bark, and he seems to have good success with that. Here's my second set of acquisitions from the Montreal Orchid Expo. As you can see, they're all Phragmopediums. This is from Frags Plus, a Canadian grower, basically almost my backyard, I guess. This first one is called Elfin's Candy. I don't think this is blooming size yet, because the lead plant only has like four leaves, and I don't know, I've not ever seen a Phragmopedium make a spike unless it's had at least six leaves, so I think these are all good size, but I'm thinking that maybe next year this plant will, maybe next spring, we're gonna have a spike on this one, assuming that it likes living in its new home. The second one that I bought is another red cross, I hope, anyways. I'm sure that it is. It doesn't have a name yet, but it's a cross between Green Hornet times Inca Fire. Green Hornet is not red, but Inca Fire is, and usually the red color in crosses seems to dominate, so I can't wait to see what this looks like. This was a freebie. I guess this one must grow like a weed for the grower. This cross is Taras times Green Hornet, and it's been given a name, Elfin's Blotch. This is from Piping Rock Orchids, and at the time it was in bud. There were no flowers. And 12 days later, this is the lead flower here. This one's been opened now since maybe, I don't know, 12 days or so. It's probably on its way out. But to my surprise, the second flower opened while the first one was still opened. So it hasn't fallen off yet. And in the back, there appears to be something, so I'm fairly certain there's going to be another bud popping up out of this. Cross for this one. This is a primary hybrid. Phragmopedium Bassii crossed with Boisseriano. Piping Rock sells the most amazing lady slippers. Everything is always in good shape when I buy them. And as a matter of fact, it's my only in-bud purchase from this year's show. So I'm savoring this one. So hopefully the flowers will last another couple of weeks. Here's another Phragmopedium purchase from Piping Rock. This one is not in bud, but it's a really, really nice one. It's a previously bloomed one. So, you see that there was a spike here before. So, it's growing a leaf, a new leaf here. Doing okay here. Looks alright. That's how much I paid for it. Living in Canada, with the exchange rate, everything is more expensive. But the cross is something new. I think it's a newly registered cross of Phragmopedium Eric Young. Phragmopedium Red Rocket. It's registered under the name QF Red Wings. So it should be interesting. Should be interesting to see what it gives. But Red Rocket actually has some Jason Fisher in it. So I've tried to get a Jason Fisher